The last NDA that we signed last week is the third of three NDAs with the ASIC manufacturers. These are large companies who make serious investments behind a chip. There are at least $30 million of indirect investments. And these companies wouldn't enter into NDA lightly.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Francesco Gardin. He's the CEO of Quantum Blockchain Technologies. Francesco, very good to speak with you. You've prioritized the software version of Method C for a faster commercial rollout, and it looks like you're making very good progress. Take us through the essence of today's announcement.
Okay. Good morning, Stephen. Thank you very much for the opportunity. There's more. The story is very simple. The last NDA that we signed last week is the third of three NDAs with the ASIC manufacturers. These are large companies who make serious investments behind a chip. There are at least $30 million of indirect investments. And these companies wouldn't enter into NDA lightly because once we have an NDA in place, then they must allocate resources, very expensive resources, which they take away from the production and the design of their next generation chip. And so in the case of this last company, for example, I mean, the initial approach was in January. So before getting one of these very large organizations to sign an agreement, in our case, it was like 10 months. So these are not things which move quickly when you're dealing with very large corporations. Now, while we are going ahead with the mutual understanding of how to integrate the IP of Method C, the hardware version, we, as we announced 2 weeks ago, after a lot of hard work, we came, and thanks to our AI development team, they came up with a software version, which means that we can install this version, which is not alternative, but is in addition to the hardware version on the operating system, which means a deployment time, which is a matter of weeks rather than a year and a half in the case of a chip. So all these companies are keen, as well as investigating the hardware implementation, to go for the software implementation, because all three of them are also selling systems. So not only developing ASIC chips, but selling systems, which means that they could boost the performance of their system just by updating the operating system with our Method C Oracle in a software version.
Francesco, so you've announced that you've now signed NDAs with three ASIC manufacturers and a Bitcoin mining pool. How would these collaborations position these companies for competitive advantage in the Bitcoin mining sector?
Okay, in this sector, if you are not the leader, then you really to do very hard work to catch up with people who have been invested hundreds of millions in this sector. So we are perceived as an opportunity to reduce this gap by adding our technology to their system and their chips. So we are a chance for these people to recover the time lost in the past because they were not early enters in the field.
With Method C potentially improving hashing efficiency, how do you see this translating into revenue streams or licensing opportunities for QBT over the next few years?
Well, there are many opportunities. So either we get revenue for each system sold, or we get the other alternative is that we get hash rate, for example, every day we get half an hour of hash rate for us. So there are many different ways to get remuneration or sell the technology. If the results are more encouraging than are today, and we are continuously improving them, even mining, because we will be mining with the same cost as everybody else, but with much higher productivity. So we have a variety of options that we can choose. But what is really important is that we are sitting on a unique technology. If you ask today to the like of ChatGPT, QBT doing, quantum blockchain technology doing, possible? ChatGPT will tell you that is not possible. Clearly, ChatGPT is basing his assessment on what is known today. So we shouldn't be surprised that it takes 10 months from the initial approach to convince a company where the first thing they tell you is that what you do is impossible. And then we show the numbers. And then they start to think, oh, maybe that's not really impossible. But then they want to see a system, one of their system running without software, and check the number themselves. So it's a long sales cycle, but we're not surprised, and we were actually expecting that it wouldn't be easier, because what we are proposing is something that everybody believes is impossible, but it's working.
Francesco, you're actually working on patent applications in Europe and the US. How critical is intellectual property to your strategy, and when might investors expect a further development?
These patents are assets which protect our technology, but they are also innovation which could prevent other people from selling their technology. So there are different ways to take advantage of these patents. Recently, we are less inclined to patent some of the new discoveries because after 18 months, it has to become public, or you decide not to continue with the application. So some of our technology, we deliberately decided not to patent and to keep it that industrial secret, because we want to protect this in the years to come.
Well, Francesco, I hope you'll continue to keep us updated on your progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you.
Francesco Gardin is CEO of Quantum Blockchain Technology.